intimidation factor. You get what I'm saying?
So he intimidate the coaches and the play callers?
You got to think about this. Belichick.
They don't sweat when they down.
Belichick. Belichick would sit back there. You see when they was down, they started doing trick plays. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
Everybody talk about Tom Brady. I want to talk about the game. Belichick and how he went over there probably to McDaniels and told him, Joe, let's change this shit up. Because this basic shit ain't working against this fast-ass defense. We got to confuse them a little bit. And when New England started doing that, that's when I start seeing progress. You get what I'm saying? The flickeries and the trick play. That's when you start seeing progress. That defense was too good for them to play Patriot football. They had to switch it up. And that's when I start giving credit to them. All in and out, it was a good game. It was a good game for real. No bullshit. It was a good game.
Remember when you were talking about, remember I said, you know, how was they going to stop Gronk? And then you went on the set and you told me.
I told them they going to hit him.
You told me. And what they did.
And they hit him.
And then what I said, well then, how they going to stop Cooks? Remember I said that? I said, how they going to stop Cooks?
Cooks dropped an open. Ooh, he dropped a wide said, open and that could have changed the game.
I said, how they going to stop
Cooks? On a trick play. He could have, he called more.
Because he had a 100, right? He had a buck.
Who?
Cooks.
The receiver?
The receiver. Because you said, and your point was valid. You said, I said, Black Kid, how they going to stop Grunt? Because he can't be stopped. You said they're going to hit him. Boom! He got hit. Concussed out.
You hit something
for no, he got hit that first time and he felt that shit.
I was going to make a post saying, I wonder how long Grunt going to play in this game. I swear to God I was going to make that post.
For real, they going to hit his ass.
It's every time this dude's doing this.
That boy, that boy, man, he balled. And then your boy, I think, Amendola, the dude I said was served, but y'all said
he came on late.
You were thinking of Edelman.
Amendola came on late. Amendola actually was the savior for that offense on that at the end of the game, Joe. He was the savior, Joe.
To give Tom Brady
that white
credit,
boy can play, man.
I'm gonna tell you
I like
what Tom
him.
Brady did.
He can play.
Also, I'm going to tell you what he did. He punched him in the mouth by speeding that game up. He went no huddle.
Yeah, and that fourth he did.
Got it on 3-19. I say, well, shit.
And that fourth he did.
And they killed him with the like. I want to say they ran the same play a couple of times, and they scored on two of them. They remember when he sent what's name number 80 in motion. He caught him underneath. Remember when he sent him in motion, caught him over
and
the
top. And that's why I was saying.
I can't take nothing from Tom Brady in that situation.
Okay. That's why I was saying when they got away from playing straightforward New England football and got to playing like the trickery football. That's when I was like, oh, damn, man, we might have a problem.
But you know what?
That's what they call
that's
it. We're too
that's
like.
Been there before that's able to do that on a fly.
That was a coach.
Not only that, Belichick.
Understanding and adjusting that.
Because
it wasn't Brady, it was Belichick.
And his squad,
so let's get this in order. I'm tired of this Brady credit shit.
But guess what
it's
I gave
Belichick,
him? Guess what I
told
man.
Him
yesterday. Yeah. It was still Bortles game to win or lose, and he lost.
And he lost it. Critique Bortles play.
Bortles, let me tell you.
What grade would you give?
Let me tell you. What I give Bortles?
And critique
his I give Bortles an A-.
Okay.
You know why I give Bortles an A-? I give Bortles an A- because Bortles' accuracy and his completion was on point. It went. Sometimes he went 5 for 5, 6 for 6, 12 for 12. I'm like, damn. And I mean, it was on the money. It was he putting it right there. Now, this is what we argued about yesterday. The last play, when he scrambled up out of that blitz.
Threw off that off leg.
And he was on the run throwing it. That ball was on the money for to hit that receiver going. I don't know where this dude came from, but he caught up like and made an athletic play.
Deion Sanders.
Bortles couldn't throw that ball no better. Dude just made a hell of a play, and I took my hat off and said, I can't say nothing about that right there.
Like only reason
that was a well-thrown ball, and that was a well-defended play. Nothing else I can say, Joe.
Only thing I had said, and if you look at it, the receiver's doing this. If he had to do this, dude ain't catching that. He ain't tipping that ball. That's why I said he probably
like, if you look at that play, this dude jumped up.
So imagine
when he landed on his back. He landed on his back to bat the ball. So you know how athletic that play was then, right?
I said he did make a great play. I said,
so that means that ball was on the money and making it there because if it would have went over his fingertips, even if he would have tipped it, that ball would have been caught. Touchdown. We would have had a whole nother thing all over again in Minnesota, Joe. No bullshit.
So again, I go from catching like this. If catch like this,
dude, that dude, that dude made a good play.
But only thing I see, put a little bit too much on
him. Boy, threw it on the run.
And he threw on the run off that, off the wrong
back
leg.
Back foot or whatever.
Threw it off, like it's like off his, he was going to his left leg when he threw it.
And that was a great game.
Hell of a game.
That was a good way to
try. Do you respect Bortles? After all our shit, I just said, you had a chance to see him. You had a chance to see him. Y'all had a chance to see him on the big stage. And he didn't rattle. Y'all respect him now.
The
Pittsburgh game.
That's when I was like, because when he won against Buffalo, I was like, dude, you threw for 87 yards. You got 87.
But he rushed for 88 and a touchdown.
You gonna get? He was a gamer that against Buffalo.
But against
he played football that game.
But yeah, Fournette that killed that game. So he, that's why. Now you go back to my point when I said, run the ball. Then like you even said, you got T.Y. Yeldon. You got two. You got a double head back there. You gotta punish them, dude. They came out passing that ball, and they left 8 minutes in the third quarter, and the boys came out dead in that third quarter.
What Roy said, say? Read what Roy said, say.
I just don't understand why coaches don't run against you when you win it.
You gotta run take their life away. You cannot get them dudes no L. You choking them, you choke them till they die.
Seattle, you lost beast mode because you didn't want to give him the MVP.
On the one. And you still had a timeout.
He had the MVP, and he wouldn't have said nothing in the interview, and you wanted Russell Wilson to be the MVP of the Super Bowl, and you lost. So you didn't get the MVP, and you didn't get the championship.
And you lost a player.
And you lost a player. And you lost a player. You actually lost the whole team because everybody leaving because of that.
Y'all could have had a little dynasty going right now.
Just like Golden State.
Oh.
They could have been the Golden State of football.
Ooh.
But man, Joe, we're going to go ahead. We're going to take a music break. We're going to come back. We're going to talk about more. We're going to talk about that Bulls game yesterday. Plus, get an update on Dunn and see how he coming along. Huh? Oklahoma came back and won?
I think they interviewed
Trae Young is getting interviewed.
Oh, shit.
I gave him. It was one game I gave him.
Oklahoma came back and beat Kansas. So when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit about that game. And we're going to talk about this Cleveland and Spurs game. I'm interested in that.
Well, I want to see what stats were.
We can always look that up. That ain't no big deal. Bring A Game Sports Talk Radio. We back in y'all, man.
Big sight. New. Hey. Go. Big sight. Yeah. Y'all know how this shit go.
You know. All eyes on me.
Buffalo G.
Roll up in the club. Yeah, right. All eyes on me. All eyes on me.
You know what? I bet you got it twisted, you don't know who to trust. So many player-hating niggas trying to sound like us. Say they ready for the funk, but I don't think they know it. Straight to the depths of hell is where them cowards going. Well, are you still down, nigga? Holler when you see me. And let these devils be sorry for the day they finally freed me. I got a caravan of niggas every time we ride. Hitting motherfuckers up when we pass by. Until I die, live the life of a boss player. Cause even when I'm high, fuck with me and get cross later. The future's in my eyes. Cause all I want is cash and things. I'm 500, Benz for my flashy brains. Bitches pursue me like a dream. Been known to disappear before your eyes. It's like a dope thing. It seems my main thing was to be major paid. The game sharper than the motherfucking razor blade. Save money, bring bitches. Bitches bring lies. One nigga's getting jealous and motherfuckers die. Depend on me like the first and 15. They might hold me for a second, but these punks won't get me. We got four niggas and low riders and ski masks screaming thug like every time they pass. All eyes on me. Little life of a thug nigga until the day I die. Little life of a boss player. All eyes on me. All eyes on me. Little life of a thug nigga until the day I die. Little life of a boss player. Cause even getting high.
Hey, to my nigga Pac. So much trouble in the world, nigga. Nobody feel your pain. The world's changing every day. Time's moving fast. My girl said I need a race. How long will she last? I'm caught between my woman and my pistol and my chips. Triple bean, got some smokers on, whistle as a dip. I'm lost in the land with no plan, living life flawless. Crime boss, contraband, let me toss this. Mediocre's got a lot of nerve, let my bucket swerve. I'm taking off from the curb. The nervousness, neglect made me pack a tech. Devoted to serving this, my wet and paid checks. Like a kite satellite, nigga, I'm forever ballin'. It ain't right, parasites, triggers, and fleas crawling. Suck a duck and get busted, no emotion. My devotion.
ocean is out of my business, nigga, and keep on coasting. Where you going? I've been there, came back, it's lonely, homie. Steady flowing against the grain, nigga, still don't know me. It's about the money and this rap shit, this crap shit. It ain't funny, niggas don't even know how to act shit. What can I do? What can I say? Is there another way? Plus it's gin all day, 24 parlay. My little homie G, can't you see I'm Busta Free? Niggas can't stand me, all eyes on me.
Little life is a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Little life is a boss play, all eyes on me. All eyes on me. Live the life of a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Live the life of a boss play. All eyes on me.
The fans is watching, niggas plotting to get me. Will I survive? Will I die? Come on, let's picture the possibility, giving me charges. Lawyers making a grip. I told the judge I was raised wrong, and that's why I blaze shit. Was hyper as a kid, old as a teenager. On my mobile calling big shots, on the scene major, packing hundreds in my drawers. Fuck the law, bitches I fuck with a passion. I'm living rough and raw, catching cases at a fast rate, balling in the fast lane. Hustle till the morning, never stop until the cash came. Live my life as a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Live my life as a boss player, cause even getting high, these niggas got me tossing shit. I put the top down, now it's time to floss my shit. Keep your head up, nigga, make these motherfuckers suffer. Up in the bins, burning rubber, the money is mandatory. The hoes is for the strap, this criminal lifestyle. Equipped with the bulletproof vest, make sure your eyes is on the meal ticket. Get your money, motherfucker, let's get rich and we'll kick it. All eyes on me.
Little life is a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Little life is a boss player.
All eyes on me.
All eyes on me.
Little life is a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Little life is a boss player.
All eyes on me. All eyes on me.
Pay attention, my niggas. See how that shit go? Nigga walk up in this motherfucker and be like, ding.
Till the day I die. Bitches, even getting high.
Every motherfucking body. I got busted hoes and police watching a nigga, you know?
Living life as a thug, nigga, till the day I die. Living life as a boss player.
All eyes on me.
It's like what they think.
Renegade Gang Sports Talk Radio. Chilling down here on this Tuesday. Y'all can catch the podcast later on the website. That's BringAGameSportsTalkRadio.com. Plus, y'all can also catch it on BlackHippieRadioEntertainment.com. But we live right now on the air. Got the homie Smokey D. He done called in. So chilling down here with your Tim Young and the homie Corey C.L. Crockett. Right now, we finna talk about a little bit of basketball.
That All Eyes on Me is a classic, though.
Oh, it's always got to be a classic.
Hey, we can't not let Tupac get played, and ain't nobody gonna say nothing about that
song.
He gonna
play two Tupac songs off that album.
Y'all tripping. y'all not gonna let Tupac get played and not say nothing about what just played.
But we got the call on the last. Smokey D, what up, Joe?
Yo, what up with you?
Shit, how you, man? Well, yeah, you down at the Hound?
Man.
You down at the Hound?
Yeah, I'm down at the Hound. Of course, I ain't by myself.
You got some people down there, what they want?
Oh, man, we got some people down want to get their input on things.
What they want to get their input on?
Well, whatever the next subject is, you know what I'm saying?
You
ready to talk?
Hey, Smokey D, how my friends doing down there now?
Why don't you come on down here, man?
Hey, man, no more parties in L.A., man. We ain't going to talk about that right now, man. Hey, but check it out, though. We finna talk about NBA basketball. We talk about that Bulls game yesterday that we was watching. Yesterday, the Bulls, they lost in double overtime to the Pelicans. Let me check out this score right here. I thought I had the score up. I didn't took the motherfucker down.
They losing.
Yeah, the Bulls, they lost 132-28 to the Pelicans yesterday. And let's talk about Zach LaVine, his play first. What y'all think about Zach LaVine's play? Because they kept him in the fourth quarter this time around.
He ain't no closer, I know that.
He's not no closer, most
definitely
not. He
had 19, but half of the team had like 15 or 14 or better.
I mean, he's not a superstar. He's a good player. And he played like a good player because he didn't want no pause or Holiday. Holiday was just like bodying him. You know what I mean? He was a little out of control trying to draw contact and force the ref to like call fouls. And in games like that, especially when you got like three all-stars on the floor, you gotta just play basketball. You
exactly.
gotta get those calls.
Exactly.
He sure thought he could.
What you think, Smokey D? What you thought about the game yesterday?
I thought, man, the Bulls had the opportunity to win the game. I got a motherfucker here think Boogie is the best damn center it is, and I keep telling them he ain't.
But he is.
He's not.
But he is. Who was that Smokey D?
He sound like dude off Martin. But he like, is. Sit your ass down.
Angry man. Please.